Thank you, Lord. Thank you. And welcome to Kilkenny Community Church. It's so good to be able to meet together, and I'm so glad to be here. So it's good to be in the house of the Lord. Do you know, and we think about our brothers and sisters in Christ who are being persecuted right now because of their faith. Those in Afghanistan and other places, Lord, I just thank you for the freedom that we have in you. Thank you, Lord. So he says in Psalm 150, praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty firmament. Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent greatness. Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the lute and harp. And we praise him with all of everything that we've got here today. So let us give God the glory and honor today. Thank you, Lord. Let's stand and let's praise the Lord. Thank you, Patience and team.
Thank you, Jean.
These are the days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord. And these are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored. And though these are days of great trial, of famine and darkness and sword, still we are the voice in the desert crying, prepare ye the way of the Lord. Behold, he comes riding on the clouds, shining like the sun, at the trumpet call. Salvation come. And these are the days of Ezekiel, the dry bones becoming as flesh. And these are the days of your servant David, rebuilding the temple of praise. And these are the days of the harvest. The fields are as white in the world. And we are the laborers in your vineyard, declaring the word of the Lord. Behold, lift your voice from the year of Jubilee, out of Zion's hill, salvation comes.
These are the days of Ezekiel.
These are the days of Ezekiel. The dry bones becoming as flesh. And these are the days of your servant David, rebuilding the temple of praise. And these are the days of the harvest. The fields are as white in the world. And we are the declaring the word of the Lord. Behold, he comes riding on the clouds,
yes,
shining like the sun,
yeah,
at the trumpet call. the clouds, shining like the sun. Have the trumpet call, lift your voice, the year of Jubilee. Out of Zion's hill, salvation comes.
Amen. We're going to sing There's No One Like Jehovah, yeah? Are you ready?
There's no one like Jehovah. 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 There's no one like Jehovah.
There's
no one like Jehovah.
There's no one like Jehovah.
There's no one like Jehovah. There's no one like Jehovah. There's no one like Jehovah. There's no one like Jehovah. There's no one like Jehovah. There's no one like Jehovah.
Behold,
behold, he comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice.
We did this in the first meeting. I want you to turn to your neighbor and tell him there's no one like Jehovah, yeah? Yeah? Don't be shy, yeah? Okay, let's sing it. Sing it to your neighbor. Here we go.
There's no one like Jehovah.
Yeah.
There's no one like Jehovah. 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 Behold, he comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun.
There's no one like Jehovah, amen? Hallelujah. It's good that we declare it, amen? And we say it to each other to encourage each other, amen? Amen.
There's no one like Jehovah. There's no one like
come
Jehovah.
Come on now.
There's no one like Jehovah. 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 There's no one like Jehovah.
There's no one.
There's no one like Jehovah. 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 Behold, he comes riding on the
Amen. Hallelujah. to Jesus. Woo! God, you're so good. You're so good. Woo! He's so good. Amen. You have something to thank God for. He's awesome. Amen. He's good all the time. The devil is a bad devil and God is good. Yeah? All the time. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. We bless you this morning, Lord. We love you this morning, Lord. We ask you to help us to worship you, Lord. Let our focus be you today, Lord. Oh, Lord Jesus. Let it not be on man, Lord, today. Let it be you, Jesus, today. Hallelujah. We give you praise, Lord. We give you honor. We give you glory. We give you the praise, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We worship you. We bless you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Your
Good afternoon again, and welcome to Kilkenny Community Church. Before I go any further, I just want to share a scripture that I believe is for at least one person here today. I was all night long, I had this scripture, "Be still and know that I am God." It's Psalm 46, verse 10. This is, and it says, "I will be exalted upon the nations," but it's, "Be still and know that I am God." And I believe whatever it is you're going through, whoever this is for, Papa wants you to rest in his loving arms and be still. And he said he will sustain you. Thank you, Lord. So, I tell you what, let's stand. We've got our guest speaker here today. Let's give him a Kilkenny Community Church honour and give him a big hand of applause. Thank you, Dermot.
Okay, everybody hear me?
Hello, Houston.
Well, thanks very much. Bless you all. You're all good?
Yes.
Come on, you're a bit more livelier than the last few people who are here. Praise the Lord, amen. Not that they weren't lively, but, but you're all looking well. Praise God. You're all good?
Yes.
You're all strong in the Lord, amen.
Yes.
Anybody here don't know Jesus? Praise the Lord, amen. Praise God this morning. Well, it's good to be here again. Thanks so much, pastors, for having us. It's an honor to come anytime to come and just share Jesus. You know, I don't care if it's in a podium or on the street, in a corner, in a workplace, alley, little, whatever. It doesn't make a difference to me. I just love to share about him. Amen. This is my amazing wife over here. Her name is Guna. That's our little daughter, Rebecca. A blessing of the Lord. Amen. Praise God. Well, hallelujah. Well, it's good to be here. We were on the streets yesterday. We went up into the parade here. Is the parade the college, yeah? Is that it, Anne? Yeah, it's the parade. Yeah, we were up. It's a good friend, Anne, down there. Bless her. And we put the cross up. And it was great. We shared Jesus. We shared the gospel. We preached the gospel. And people heard the word. Some people prayed the salvation prayer. Some people we prayed for. Others just signed the cross. Well, let me tell you, no matter where we go, you see this cross? You know, Paul says the message of the cross, it's foolishness to those who are perishing, but to those who believe, it's the power of God unto salvation. And you know, I think, you know, and again, I'm not talking about this church now, but we need to bring the cross back into the message of the church, amen? We're never in such an hour and a time where we need to hear the message of the cross, amen? The message of salvation, the message that sets you free. You see, it's the power of God unto salvation. It's that simple message of salvation, that God loves you. Jesus came and died for you. His blood was spilled for you. He was wounded for your transgressions. He was bruised for your iniquities. The very chastisement of all these peace was upon him. Your peace was upon Jesus. And by his stripes, you were healed. Amen? You were healed of every affliction, every day. You were healed of denominationism. And I just throw that out there. Amen? I was healed of that. Praise the Lord. you know, he healed you. No matter what it is, God has already provided healing for you. Amen? You know, Paul put it 1 Corinthians 15, verses 1 to 6. He said, you know, this is the message that I preach. He said, I didn't get it from a man. You see, he didn't have a doctorate or he didn't have some sticker on the wall. He didn't have a lovely plaque to say I was in Bible college. No, he got a message from Jesus. Amen. And that message was that he died for your sins. And he rose again on the third day. Amen. He was whipped on a post for you, stripped naked, and paraded before the public for you. Amen. And his blood cleansed all of your sin. Amen. I just want to let you know this morning, every sin you've ever committed, if you've given your life to Jesus, has been washed in the blood. Amen. Everything he did for you, he did on that cross. He did it till you'd be free. Amen. There wasn't some things that he might have done. There wasn't some things that he left behind. There wasn't some things that he left that we have to put up with. No, every single thing that you're going through, Jesus already paid the price. Amen. Now, that's not even what I want to preach on this morning, but I'm just throwing that in to get your head right. Amen. This morning. Amen. Because, you know, I read a great book, and if you ever get a chance to read it at the moment, I like to read. I love to read. Before I got saved, the only thing I ever read was the sun, yeah? It was Praise Tree and the sun, and the other one was the horoscopes, amen? But when I got saved, I got an insatiable hunger for Jesus, amen? An insatiable hunger for His Word. Insatiable hunger for everything to do with Jesus. But there's a book called How to Keep Your Head on Straight in a World Gone Crazy. Okay, it's by Rick Renner. If you ever get a chance, read that book. An amazing book, amen. Because let me tell you, the world has gone crazy. Anybody know that the world has gone nuts, amen? Yeah. You know, we're kind of nuts, but we're screwed to the right bolt, amen. Glory to God, amen. We're screwed into Jesus, amen. Hallelujah, praise the Lord, amen. But the world has gone crazy. Come on, isn't it gone crazy? Confusion everywhere. You know what I mean? Some people think they're a man. Some people think they're a woman. You know, one day you're something else, then something else today. You know, listen to me. In Matthew 24, Jesus, He said in the last days, the very first thing that would come up, the very first thing that would be evident for the world to see was mass deception. Amen. Mass confusion. If you look up that word. Amen. Hallelujah. Man, I'm not even preaching a message, man. I'm just, praise the Lord. I'm just talking to you this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. I feel I have a little bit more time, amen, you know, but I want to get you into here. Listen, you know, I'm telling you, what you're listening to these days is going to affect your head, amen. It's going to affect your mind. It's going to affect your heart, amen. What you're giving your eyes to, what you're giving your ears to, it's so important in these days. Listen to me, whether you believe it or not, Jesus is about to come back, amen. He's about to bust open the sky and come and take His church, amen, in Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. And I want to share this scripture before I get into what God has for us this morning. I want to share this scripture because in Matthew, Acts 27, I was sitting worshiping there. The Lord gave me this scripture and He said, listen, this is something we need to understand. Listen, at the moment, we've been bombarded by everything that's coming from the media, coming from the world, coming from the HSC and the government. And listen to me, that's all fine. We understand all that. But let me tell you, you cannot be persuaded more about that than you are by what God says in His Word. Amen. You know, I'm telling you now this morning, you got to get your head on straight, amen, because we got to believe God, amen. We got to trust Him for everything, amen. His Word is true, amen. He will never fail us. You know, my wife is here, so I can't say it. God is always right, and so is my wife, amen. You know, God is always right. His Word never fails, amen. What He says is what He'll do, amen. Amen. But if you look at Acts 27, you know, again, Paul in Acts 26 was before King Agrippa, and he gave his testimony. And when he gave his testimony to King Agrippa, he always, King Agrippa said, I'm always most persuaded to be a Christian. You know, Paul, you're gone off your head, like, you know, I'm just putting it in Tipperary language, okay? He said, like, you know, you're not even persuading me to become a Christian, he said. And in that moment, he said, listen, I appeal to Caesar. Paul said, I appeal to Caesar. And in that moment, Agrippa made a decree. He said, I'm going to send you to Caesar. And he tied him up with a centurion soldier. Okay? And he put him on a ship head bound for Rome. Okay? But in the midst of all that, Paul said, listen to me. Listen, we shouldn't get on that ship. Okay? We shouldn't get on that ship because there's something going to happen. I have a witness from God. We get on that ship. We get involved in that and it's not going to turn out good, amen? And Paul's word came to pass, amen? It came to pass. But in this scripture, I want to give it to you here. It's in Acts 27 and verse 11. Even though Paul said, don't get on the ship, he said the centurion was more persuaded by the helmsman than the owner of the ship that the thing spoken by Paul. I'm telling you, we're in an hour right now where we need to be more convinced by what God says in His word than anything else contrary to that. Amen. Because you have many voices speaking to you today. You have a lot of things coming into our world and it's speaking things contrary to what God says in His Word. And it's so important. I know in this church it's a word church. And I'm not, you know, saying that, but I'm just saying for our personal lives. Amen. You know, Paul, in that, if you read Acts 27, they should have listened to Paul. Because they went into a cyclone. They gave 14 days in a cyclone. For the last 18 months of our lives, friends, we've been involved in a cyclone. The church has been trying to shut down. You know, the enemy has tried to shut us up. He's tried to shut us down, segregate us, isolate us. He's tried to do all that. But let me tell you, I'm more persuaded by what God says in His Word than anything else the enemy is trying to tell me at this moment. Amen. Because there's a spirit of fear has been sent out against the church. It's been sent out against the believer. It's come from hell, I'm telling you. Can I get an amen this morning? You know, whether you believe it or not, let me just wreck your head more, okay? You know, the enemy has sent a spirit of fear. And it's sent out to restrict us and separate us, isolate us, shut us up, amen? But let me tell you, God is real, amen? And His word will never fail us, amen? I'm telling you today, I am more persuaded by what God says in His word than anything that comes from anything else, amen? And this morning, I want to preach a message out of Mark chapter 4 about a woman who was isolated, who was absolutely segregated, who was pushed into the darkness because of her condition in her life. She was segregated and isolated. And let me, whether you admit it or not today, many of us in this room today have suffered with our mental health, have suffered with our thinking, have suffered against whether we should do this or we shouldn't do that, whether we should, whether we should believe what we're being told or not believe what we're being told. But let me tell you, you can take your eyes off of all that stuff today and put your eyes on Jesus, amen? You can put your eyes on the cross, on the simplicity of the message of Jesus, that I'll never leave you nor forsake you, that no matter what comes, what storm it is, whether you're 2 weeks in a cyclone, Paul went through 2 weeks in a cyclone, but let me tell you, even though that ship was wrecked and everything else was around him, he ended up on the shore because he grabbed hold of something the Bible says, a piece of wood. He gave his faith to God and he ended up on the shore. He didn't drown, and it's going to be the same for us, amen. Hallelujah. You see, we come out smiling, amen. We're going to come out shining, amen. You'll be like you went to dental clinic, your teeth will be ding ding. I'm telling you, you're going to come out shining, amen. Praise the Lord. Why? Because Jesus has already given us the victory at the cross, amen. He's already given us the victory. So no matter what storm you've been going through, whether it is COVID-19, whatever your pandemic, whatever you've been going through in your personal life, whether it's family, because listen to me, the enemy is trying to divide families with all everything with vaccines and all the stuff that goes with all that. The enemy is trying to divide us. But let me tell you, the Bible says in Psalm 133, where your brethren, our family members, anybody dwell together in unity, God commands a blessing, amen? The blessing of the Lord that makes you truly rich and adds no sorrow with it, according to Proverbs 10:22. A blessing that comes from God, amen. A blessing that nothing can break, amen. I'm telling you, we're in these days now. And it was such a blessing to be out and just plant the cross in Kilkenny here yesterday and began to preach the gospel. We traveled through this pandemic, we haven't stopped. We've seen hundreds come to Christ. We've traveled over the nation, across the nations, and we've seen hundreds come to Christ. Thousands, I believe, even. And we've reached people through preaching of the gospel on the streets. And again, nothing to do with me. I'm just doing what Jesus told us to do. Go into all the world and preach the gospel. Amen. Whether it's in your Lidl, your post office, whether it's on the streets of London or it's in, America, wherever it is, on Dublin, wherever it is, here in Kilkenny, whatever it is, you go and preach the gospel. Amen. Because that's the message that brings salvation. Everything else is peripheral. Everything. Everything you're hearing is peripheral to the message of the gospel. Amen. Hallelujah. So I'm excited this morning. I mightn't look it, but I'm really excited. Amen. Praise the Lord. Anybody excited? Amen. Anybody excited this morning? Amen. I'm telling you, we're in the best days of ever. Amen. We're in the greatest days. Amen. I'm telling you, we're in the greatest time. Praise the Lord. Amen. Man, you've already heard the message. I've heard this already, and I'm excited on the inside. Amen. Because when God began to show me this message, He was saying to me, this is a message for the church, Dermot. This is a message for me personally, first and foremost, but it's a message for the body of Christ. It's a message for not only Kilkenny Church, Community Church here, but it's a message for the national body of Christ in Ireland. That, listen to me, we're coming out. Amen. Hallelujah. We're coming out into a time where God is going to make us shine. Amen. I'm telling you, God is resurrecting His church. Praise God. The enemy has tried to divide us, try to put us down, try to lock us away and separate us. How many people are zoomed out of their head? Amen. Praise the Lord. You know what I mean? The Bible says not to forsake the assembling yourself together as some do, but especially as the day of the Lord comes. Amen. All that's happening in the world now just emphasizes in me that Jesus is about ready to come back. Amen. And take His church home. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah this morning. Well, you're kind of trying to figure that one out in your head at the moment. It's okay. Praise God. Amen. Just relax. Amen. God, let the word do the work. Amen. In Jesus' name. Mark chapter 5. Let's just have a jump over there. Is that okay this morning? Come on. Give me an amen this morning. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on. A bit better than the last 10 o'clock crew. Come on. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. Glory to God, amen. God is real, amen. He saves, redeems, sets free. He's still doing it, amen. Man, we see it all the time. I was in London last week. I don't know where I was, a week ago or something anyway, yeah. Maybe 2 weeks ago, was it, sweetie? We were in London, and we've seen people being set free, addictions, devils coming out of people. Devils still come out of people, praise God, amen. Don't look at your neighbor, praise the Lord, amen. It's like, devils still come out of people, amen. We've seen young ladies set free in meetings where they'd never been in church before. God is bringing a harvest in. People are coming into the churches. One man, one church was in. 65% of his church left during the pandemic. And then the Spirit of God broke out in his church. And for the last 6 months, the church has trebled in size. People who have never known Jesus. People coming in off the streets. People coming in and saying, you know, someone told me that my friend down the road got delivered from drug addiction here last week at the altar. I want to come and be prayed for. You know, this is where we're at. This is the times we're in, amen. The church, and God is bringing his church out, amen. He's bringing it out to a glorious church, amen. Without spot or wrinkle, hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah this morning, praise God, amen. Man, I'm telling you, I'm excited on the inside. I mightn't look it, but I am, amen. I'm excited because, you know, God is real. He's not just some made up, you know what I mean, and he does things now and again. He will confirm his word, amen. Hallelujah, praise God, amen. Glory to God this morning, amen. Hallelujah. Father, I take authority in this place over the spirit of fear right now in Jesus' name. Amen. I take authority over every person over. And I'm going to pray right now. Amen. I really want to pray. Amen. Lord, I just pray right now, Father, in Jesus' name. We come against the spirit of fear in our minds in the name of Jesus. We come against every influence bar your Holy Spirit in our lives in Jesus' name. Lord, I break off every condition in the mind, every stronghold that's been built up over the last 18 months of negativity, of lies, and some stuff in essence just fear in Jesus' name. Amen. Lord, we don't deny that the pandemic is there. We don't deny all that. We don't deny it, but faith says that it can come against it. Amen. In Jesus' name. So I break it off you this morning. I loose you from it. Amen. In Jesus' name. You know, some of you need to just get up and say, yeah, thank you, Jesus. I'm free from that right now. Amen. In the name of the Lord. If you look at Acts 27, you see Paul, when he landed on the shoreline and he'd come through 2 weeks of a cyclone, he'd been battered left, right, and center. People on the boat wanted to throw him over the side. Any of your family members want to do that lately? Amen. And let me tell you, they thought he was nuts. But when he landed on the shore, the rain came and he built a fire. And in that moment, a snake came up and it bit him on the hand. But what did he do? He just shook it off. Amen. In Jesus' name. Some of you got to shake off the stuff the pandemic has tried to put on you. Some of you got to shake off the stuff that the enemy has tried to bring in through fear in your life. Amen. You got to shake it off, my friend. Amen. In Jesus' name. Just give it a good shake like that. You know, amen. It's okay. It's all right. Shake it off. That's it. Come on, shake it off today. Lord, I shake off all the trauma. I shake off all the fear. I shake off all the division, Lord. I shake it all off, Lord, today in the name of Jesus, God. I shake off all the division in my family right now. I shake off all the division in the church right now in Jesus' name. I shake it all off, Lord, and I thank you, Lord, that you are bringing me out. Amen. And if you read the rest of Acts 27, it worked out really well for Paul. Amen. You know, he got the guy who led the island saved. Amen. And then he was put up in a big house. And they gave him loads of money and sent him off on one of the greatest ships. If you study it out, he was sent back like a cruise ship in those days. He headed off to Rome in a cruise ship. So let me tell you, some of you might have gone through some stuff, but you're coming out, amen? Yeah. I'm telling you, some of you are just going to come out so sweet. God's going to bring you out of it, I'm telling you. You're going to be shining coming out the other side, you know. What pandemic are you talking about? Glory to God. Yeah, I'm telling you. Well, I tell you, I'm just saying right now, I'm not boasting. I'm a bit like, but it's okay. through the pandemic, you know, we prospered more in this pandemic than we did in the 4 or 5 years in our ministry before that. Absolutely, the blessing of the Lord. Just the blessing of the Lord. People just helping us and donating and I'm telling you, this is amazing. Like, yeah. I actually have a business as well, you know, I have a brokerage business that I use, and that just doubled. Yeah. Hallelujah. See, God is good, amen. He is good and his blessings endure forever. Amen. He's the good Father, amen, in Jesus' name. Some of you need to get that through in your head this morning, amen? Amen? Listen, you know, sometimes I go to raise the dead, amen? I raise the dead, you know? Sometimes I have to raise the dead, you know? Some of you come into church, you're a little bit dead, you know? And I got to raise you right up, amen, in Jesus' name, amen? Hallelujah this morning. Anybody in a panic this morning? Anybody? Because I still have to preach out of the book of Mark, amen? Amen, in Jesus' name. So that's the introduction. We love you. We bless you. And thank you so much for coming, amen. So Mark chapter 5. So here we go. Mark chapter 5. If you have your Bible this morning, say amen. Hallelujah. Did you bring your Bible this morning? Amen. Praise God. Mark chapter 5 this morning. So let me give you a bit of context in Mark chapter 5. Mark chapter 4, Jesus preached on the sower seed, the sower sowed the word, amen. You know, he sought the word because the devil comes to steal the word, amen? So whatever word is on the inside of you, the devil comes to steal, amen? So if you're going through some stuff, just rebuke the devil and get the more of the word, amen, in Jesus' name. What happened then is he got into a boat. Well, he actually sent his troops across, the disciples over in the boat to the Gadarenian demoniac. He got to the other side, cast that out. Jesus came back in the boat, and then he landed. And when he got out of the boat, he stepped out into the water, and suddenly there was a multitude of people there. If you look it out in the Greek, it's mega in the Greek. A multitude of people followed Jesus. Why? Because multitudes will follow the preaching of the word, signs and wonders, amen. And in that moment, a man called Jairus, who just absolutely was a prominent guy in the temple, you know, he would have been very well known, and I don't want to go into his history now, but he would even address, the way he dressed would have shown him as a prominent member of the Sanhedrin, or, you know, the Pharisees or whatever. In the synagogue, yeah, and in the temple. So when he arrived, they saw him coming, and the multitudes parted, and he fell down at Jesus' feet and began to beg him to come and heal his daughter. His daughter was sick. She was in the last stage. If you look it up in the Greek, she was in the last stages of a sickness, and he was saying, come and lay your hands on my daughter. You see, Jesus, when he laid hands on people, something happened, amen? See, we need that back in the church. We need the power of God back in the church, amen, in Jesus' name. So when I lay hands on people, I'm not expecting anything, only to be zapped by the Holy Spirit and God to do something, because it's no longer me who live, it's Christ living in me, amen? The anointed one and his anointing. So when Jesus turns up, when Jairus turns up, he begs. And the Bible says there was a woman who had an issue of blood for 12 years. She came out of her self-isolation. She, praise the Lord this morning. Man, this is good, amen. You know, I'm telling you, when God gave me this, he was helping me, because, you know, we travel, but I'm in a hotel room with a four-year-old, you know, and some churches, like, you know, things are going on, I'm on the streets, you're getting attacked, you know, there's stuff happening. So I'm mentally, you know, who, be honest this morning, mentally, who struggled a little bit through the pandemic? Come on, can you be honest this morning? Yeah, just be honest, amen, come on. That's okay, just be honest about it, amen, okay? Let me tell you, you see, that's the enemy. He tries to build a stronghold in your mind. So for this woman, okay, she's now, like, if you look at the Levitical law, she was unclean. So she had an issue of blood for 12 years, and according to Leviticus 17, she couldn't come out. Anything she touched, she would be stoned, okay? Yeah, and I'm not talking about the stoning now we used to be involved in, okay? So I'm talking about the stone with rocks, yeah? And you're going to be absolutely killed. So let's just pick it up in verse 25, I believe, here. Mark chapter 5 and verse 25. There was a certain woman who had an issue of blood for 12 years. This woman, right, and had suffered many things from many physicians. She'd spent all that she had and was no better, but rather grew worse. So here she was, 12 years, suffering with a condition. Under Levitical law, she couldn't leave her house. She's self-isolating. She's probably in the dark because she knows now she spent all the money she had on the physicians, and she could by no means come better, yeah? She was suffering in her mental health. Her mind, you could imagine, she's in that place, she can't come out. She can't get food, okay, because if she comes out, she's going to be stoned. So I'm thinking she has a neighbor, yeah? The Bible doesn't say that. Maybe she has a husband or a partner, or maybe she has a daughter or a son. I don't know. But somebody was bringing her food, yeah? You know, she couldn't ring Tesco's, or she couldn't, you know, WhatsApp her mate down the road and say, listen, can you go down to Super Value there in Jerusalem and get me a couple of bananas or whatever? No, she had to, like, you know, our neighbor was there, and she was saying, listen, you know, our, maybe there was a kindly neighbor who has come to her because she knew she was self-isolating, and, you know, because of what the condition she had. So they do, they bring the food and lay that at the door. And then they go back to the gate, and she'd come out and she'd open the door and she'd take her food. Does that sound familiar? Yeah. Does that sound familiar to anybody, amen? Yeah. Over this pandemic, amen? So she's in the house and she's thinking, you know, I can't come out. You know, if I was to come out, maybe, you know, she had an issue of blood. Maybe it was COVID for you. Maybe it was something. Maybe you thought you had it. Maybe you didn't think you have it. You know, whatever it might be. I'm just saying, you know, the enemy, whatever he brought into you, and you're thinking, I can't come out. I'm doing all the thing and I'm mentally suffering for all this, amen? So, you know, she's inside. But then her neighbor, I believe, began to talk about Jesus. And let's just read that right now. And then she began to talk about Jesus. So let me tell you, before we read it now, just listen to me now a second. Before you read this, right, before we read it, listen to me. She began to hear about Jesus. She began to hear about Jesus. Amen. She began to hear about Jesus. She began to hear about Jesus. 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 She turned off the radio. She turned off the TV. They didn't probably have one. But I'm just saying, she began to hear about Jesus. And let me tell you, if you put your finger or put your attention on Jesus, you're going to see some breakthrough. Amen. I'm telling you, you're going to see a miracle. Amen. You're going to see breakthrough in your thinking. You know, if you're suffering here today with an addiction or any kind of pandemic or addiction that you've been addicted to something, I'm telling you, God can break through right now in your life. Amen. In Jesus' name. Because you're hearing about Jesus. Amen. You're hearing about the message of the gospel. Amen. She heard. What was she hearing? Let's just read it, amen. And in verse 27, when she heard about Jesus, she came behind him in the crowd and touched his garment. Now, there's a lot in that statement, but she heard. The word heard there in the Greek is she began to hear about what the things that Jesus was doing. So this is her friend at the door. She's inside and she drops the bag back with her food. And then she opens it. The woman with the issue of blood, we'll call her Biddy, okay? We'll just call her Biddy. We're in Ireland, okay? So, and Mary is dropping the food back, okay? And Mary is outside the gate now and she's self-isolating and Biddy's inside and she says, "Hey, Biddy, listen, I was down at the Super Value and there's a guy down there and he's praying for people. He's putting his hands on people and they're being healed. You know Johnny, Bartimaeus, the guy that's sitting on the highway there, yeah? You know that guy? He can see now. And John's the widow's daughter, but the widow, you know, widow Murphy down there, yeah? Yeah, her son, the funeral, they're having the funeral, Biddy. They're having a funeral. And this man said, rise up and walk, get up. And he rose up, he's actually alive. No, she's like, wow. So she's hearing about Jesus. She's hearing about the miracles. She's hearing about Jesus. Listen to me, let me tell you. The things that you hear about Jesus will determine the faith for what you believe, amen? The things you hear about Christ, it brings faith for a miracle, amen? You see, if you're mixing it with the world, if you're just mixing it up with, listen, I'll read the Bible for an hour, and then I'll turn on CNN, NBC, RTE, you know, whatever, Liveline, whatever. Man, my God, deliver us from Liveline, praise the Lord, amen? Hallelujah. Lord, speak to Joe Duffy, just retire, amen, in Jesus' name. The moan line, you know? You know what I mean? Listen to me, whatever you're listening to, if you're just listening to it more than you are Jesus, you're going to have and produce what you have, but you're listening to, amen? Glory to God. He's a morning Joe. I love you, Joe. If you're listening to this, praise the Lord. You need to be saved, my friend. Amen. Hallelujah. But let me tell you what you're listening to. She heard about Jesus. What are you listening to? What are you allowing into your ear gate? What have you been allowing into this pandemic? What are you focused on more than you are on what God says in His Word? We break bread together as a family. My daughter calls it the gift. You know, we take bread and we take the juice and we break bread together. Why? Because we have more faith in that than we do in what the HSC is telling me. Amen. Now I'm not knocking that. You can do what you want, but I just believe God. Amen. And I'm not condemning anybody. I'm just saying whatever we're listening to is what is going to produce in our world. Amen. She heard about Jesus. You see, the Jesus you hear from is the Jesus you're going to receive from. Amen. If you're hearing about a Jesus that doesn't heal anymore, if you're hearing about a Jesus that sometimes turns up and maybe he's on holidays some other days, you know, if you hear about a Jesus like that, you're not going to collect anything from him. You're going to receive what you believe. Amen. And whatever you hear is what's going to bring faith for you to believe. Amen. So she's inside, tormented in her mind. 12 years now, spent everything she had. No more loans at the credit union, yeah? You know, no, nothing else. Couldn't go to the bank, the AIB. Her Jerusalem AIB card was maxed out, amen? She had the MasterCard, but it wasn't the Master's Jesus card, amen? Praise the Lord, amen? I said that, Lord, one time I'd love to have a MasterCard like you. You just be my master of my card, amen? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. She couldn't maxed out and all. She couldn't get any more. She couldn't do another thing. But let me tell you, she began to hear about Jesus. Mary was saying, Jesus is down there. I'm telling you, actually, he was over at the Gardini Demonic. You know that place over in the tombs, Biddy? Oh, yeah, I remember that place. Yeah, you know the guy that was stripped naked, running around and scared and everybody. Yeah, he's actually back in his right mind. Glory to God. Well, she probably didn't say glory to God, but you can get what I mean, yeah? So she was hearing him, and you can imagine, you know, Biddy's inside now thinking, you have, could it be possible that I touch her, John? You know what I mean? Is it actually possible that I can go outside? I can go through the door? Because let me tell you now, if I put my hand on the knob of the door, you know, everything inside me is saying I'm going to be killed if I leave this room. I'm unclean, you know? And some of you in your mentality, mental thinking, you've been thinking that over this pandemic. You know, am I clean? Am I not clean? You know, if I go down and meet my father, will I give him COVID and he'll die? You know, you've been paralyzed in your thinking, amen? But let me tell you, Jesus is real, amen? And His Word is real. And He said He'll never leave you nor forsake you. He said, whatever comes against you, if you resist it in my name, it'll leave you, amen? Even if you got sick with cancer or whatever, I'll heal you. Because I'm the healer, amen? I'm the one that delivers and sets free and heals. So she's in there and she's paralyzed by her thinking. She's absolutely, but she's going through it. She's negotiating with herself. Will I go out? Will I not? And some of you even, I said in the earlier service, Pastor, I'm so sorry I didn't bring a doorknob with me, because when God began to speak to me about that, I was thinking, God, for the next steps in our ministry, I'm a little bit apprehensive to do it, but I have my hand on the doorknob, and if I open it, I know if I step out into that, when Jesus is waiting at the other side of that door with a miracle for me, you can imagine her, she's standing at the door and her hand is on the knob. Just take her mind back to it. Take her into that room. She's unclean. She's in the dark. And her cultural mindset, everything is coming against her thinking to actually come out into the light and encounter Jesus. Amen. It's the same for everybody in this room. She's no different to you and me. Whatever you're struggling with, whatever God is calling you out of, maybe it's a lifelong fear, maybe it's a habit, maybe it's something, maybe it's I'm not good enough kind of a mentality, maybe it's, I couldn't do that job, or, I'm not good enough, or I'm not qualified enough, when the opportunity is there to encounter the Master, like he is in this room today, he's right here right now, and you can encounter him right now. He's here ready. You can just put your hand on the doorknob of your life and say, God, I open my heart to you. I open it up and I step in. I step out into the light, God. I want to touch you, Jesus. I want to feel your power. I want to know you more, Lord. I want to encounter you in a way I've never encountered you before. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm telling you, this is Jesus. Amen. Can you picture her? Yeah. Can it resonate in your heart? Maybe it's you today. Maybe you don't. I preach this message, I'll talk about that. If you don't know Jesus, you're one doorknob away from having an encounter with the living Savior. Amen. Because culture, religion, mindset, media, everything will dominate your thinking, because you're being formed, in your thinking by what you're listening to. But when you hear about Jesus, when you hear about him, when you put the gospel on, when nothing else is in your house, and you just want to listen to Jesus, you want to listen to the word and what he's saying to you. What's he, because he'll come alongside you and he'll say, listen, you can make it. You can do it. You can take that step. Don't be afraid. I know we social distance and everything, but listen, don't be afraid to hug your mom or dad. I'm with you. I'm on the inside of you. Greater is me is in you than he that's in the world. Amen. You see, this is the Jesus. Amen. This is the Jesus. Today, he wants you to know today that the pandemic is something that's come, but it's not the be-all and end-all. Amen. It shouldn't determine your life. Amen. It's only what Jesus says that determines our life. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Some of you even are being set free and you're thinking right now, I just felt the presence of God come there. Right now, he's working on your thinking because you're struggling. And you might not put your hand up, but in truth, like, yeah, praise the Lord. Because, I'm listening. I preach the gospel. But I remember when I drove over the Garda checkpoints, Pastor, yeah? Something inside me was like, was I doing something wrong? Was I going against the government? Was I going against culture? But listen, I have a mandate from God. Go into all the world. You see, that word is what I give my attention to. I'm not trying to break the law. I'm just going to do what Jesus said, amen. Today you're on the cusp of a breakthrough in your life, I believe. Today you can break through in your thinking. You can have a new mindset. You can leave this place and thinking, Jesus, I'm more persuaded, like Paul was. I'm more persuaded by what you say. Amen. Than by what the world is trying to tell me today. Amen. Mm-hmm. I'm more persuaded by that than what the world says. Amen. Yeah. Just take a moment right now. Just close your eyes for a second. Just God's presence is here. Can you sense his presence? Amen. Just let him touch you this morning. It's not about a man or a ministry. It's about Jesus. He's confirming the word. That's what he's doing. He's saying to you this morning. He wants to break. Listen, some of you have been here, you've been arguing with your family. If there's division amongst your family even over this whole thing. And God is he's releasing you from that right now. Some of you here have had COVID, and you, if you're honest, you were afraid. But let me tell you, God has not given you a spirit of fear. Only power, love, and of a sound mind. Amen. You're not what the past tells you. You're not what the government tells you. You know what I mean? You're not that. You're what Jesus says. Amen. And he says you're more than a conqueror. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This morning, Lord, we bless you in this place. Come on, just take a deep breath this morning. That's an act of faith. God has been using that in our ministry as being filled with the Holy Spirit. Just an act of your faith this morning. Take a deep breath. Say, Lord, please fill me afresh with your Holy Spirit. You know, some of you, maybe even couples here, you're being anxious with each other. You know, there's been division in you. There's stuff between you. It's the enemy. It's division. He comes to divide, kill, steal, and destroy. But Christ said, I come to give you life and give it to you more abundantly. Amen. So Lord, please, I just ask you by your gentle Holy Spirit this morning, Lord. Just touch every life in this room, God. Lord, I pray you break off every stronghold, every mindset, God, every argument of spirit. You know, some of you here, even you said, I'm right. You know, I know I'm right, and you want to be right all the time, but let me tell you, there's only one person that's right, and his name is Jesus. So even in that, in the moment, just repent of it. Say, Lord, I repent of that. I repent, Lord, of trying to be right all the time and trying to push my opinion over on other people that was contrary to what your gospel says, Lord. So, Lord, we worship you this morning. Come on, let's take a moment. Let's just worship him, amen. Hallelujah. Lord, we worship you this morning. We praise you this morning, Jesus. Lord, we give you glory. We give you praise. We honor you. Yes, you just stand up and put your hands up. Whatever you want to do, whatever you're comfortable with. But connect with Jesus, amen. Connect with him this morning, amen. Come on, connect with him this morning. Lord, we worship you. We praise you. We give you glory. We give you praise. Lord, we thank you for your presence in the place, Lord. Thank you that you're the healer. You're the bond breaker. We're persuaded more by what you say, Jesus, than by anything else in this world, Lord. And we give you our hearts afresh this morning, Lord. Come on, give him your heart afresh this morning. You speak to him, amen. Lord, I give you my heart afresh this morning. Thank you, Lord, that you're with me. You'll never leave me nor forsake me today, amen. You'll never leave me nor forsake me this morning, amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah this morning. You know, in this place of worship in a sense of his presence. You know, just to continue through with this woman, you know. The Bible says when Jairus came, you know, it tells it, you know, people, the crowd, it doesn't say it in the Bible, but, you know, culturally, the people would have parted away. He would have fell before Jesus, and he began to plead with him, the Bible says, to come and heal his daughter. And I believe in that parting. You know, God is parting things for us today. Like the woman with the issue of blood, he made a way for her to come through the crowd, the multitudes, and catch the hem of Jesus' garment. You know, the King James says that she touched his garment, but the actual Greek says she grabbed a hold of him. She grabbed the hold of his garment. This morning, my friend, you can grab a hold of Jesus, amen. You can reach out to him in your brokenness, in your stuff this morning. That's it, just let it out, my friend. If you feel like crying, do it, because God wants to touch you, amen. You know, if you feel you've been overwhelmed, or just let Jesus touch you this morning, amen. And in that moment, she touched Jesus. Can you picture it, you know? Lord, she reached out and immediately her issue was completely set free and healed in that moment. Today, Lord, my prayer is over people in this room that whatever the issue might be, God, that they be completely set free right now, God, in the name of Jesus. That they just reach out to you in their hearts, Master, and touch you, Jesus. Touch you, Jesus. Touch him. You know, the Passion Translation said that the power of God surged around him. And she tapped into that power, amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah this morning. Worship you, Jesus. And immediately her fountain dried up. Immediately. Father, we thank you for an immediately this morning, amen. And immediately in our lives, God, amen. That Lord, we say like the woman with the issue of blood, Lord, we've gone through the storm, we've gone through that now, but it's time to come out. It's time to be healed. It's time to be set free. And you know, as a prophetic picture, as I close now, as a prophetic picture of the gospel, you know, it's amazing to me that Jairus came looking to raise his daughter from the dead. And the Bible says that, you know, that the woman with the issue of blood for 12 years was in isolation. And a prophetic word for the Church of Ireland and for Kilkenny is God is raising up his church again. And he's taking it out of isolation. And it's coming out greater, stronger, more physically better. Amen. Healed and set free in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Can you say amen to that this morning?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Well, that's a word from the Lord. Amen. That's a word for the nation today. Amen. Hallelujah. So listen, before I close, I would be in awe of me as an evangelist to ask you in this room this morning, if you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, maybe you're in a place where you think you need to just reconnect with him like Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane. He rededicated his life. He said, "My will, Lord, but yours be done." He consecrated his life to his Father. I'd ask you today, if that's you, in your heart this morning, I'm going to lead you in a prayer. Amen. And if you're here, if you've never done it before, I'd ask you to sign your name on this cross. I'd ask you to sign your name or your family's name on as a mark, as an act of faith, saying, "God, my name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life, and I write my unsaved loved ones on here as an act of faith to say that they will reach heaven." Amen. In the name of Jesus. So just with me, everybody in your heart this morning, say, "Jesus, I come to you this morning, and I ask you, Jesus, to be the Lord of my life. Wash me from all my sin. Cleanse me from all my sin. And fill me with your Holy Spirit. I give you my life. The best I know how. In Jesus' name." Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord this morning. We bless you. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah this morning. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen.
Beginning and the end. How great.
How great.